better time to obviously get out and practice? We tend to talk an awful lot about the positions in the golf swing, where it should be, where it shouldn't be, which we've seen over the last few weeks. We've not really spoken much about how you put that new position into your golf swing. Obviously, through practice is how we make it happen. If you think to actually change the way in which we make a position in our golf swing, it's going to take a good 3,000 to 5,000 repetitions before it starts to get brittly placed into your golf swing. And then obviously with confidence and seeing some good results from it, then it slowly gels and becomes part of your swing. But what we tend to see when I go to a range or I'm hitting the practice ball with myself on the practice ground, I see a lot of golfers shelling out balls one after another, after another, after another. Not with any real constructive ways in which to allow your swing to develop. So, very briefly, whenever you go and practice alignment club on the floor, so whether it's another golf club in your bag or one of these practice drill sticks you can place on the floor, make sure that's running parallel to your target line, or your chosen target. Also, another thing as well is when you're practicing, make sure the wind direction is either into, or if you're right hander, slightly off the right. Try not to practice downwind or wind off the left, because that can really cause problems within your swing without really being conscious of the fact. So let's say, for example, I'm trying to work on a position in my backswing. This is how I would go about trying to make sure I could deliberately make that become part of my natural golf swing. So I've got my alignment stick on the floor. I'm checking my usual ball position and grip and posture that I know I'm already happy with. But a slight tendency to get the club a little bit around me here. So we're going to really try and exaggerate, making sure the club goes away in the right direction. A couple of those, then up to the top position. And then just swinging gently through impact. Not worrying too much how I strike the ball, where it goes, how far it goes. Really just thinking my way through that backswing. So again, making sure we've got the club on the floor to help point out our alignment, making sure all the basics are always correct as well. Even though we might be concentrating on one position up here, there's no point getting this right if suddenly our alignment and our ball position becomes wrong. So always checking your basic fundamentals. Aim, your hold, your alignment, your ball position, your posture. Then from there we're working on nice, slow, deliberate checks. Make sure the club's going in the right position. Up to the top. And then swinging it through. Not any real thought for power or how far it's going again. Without being wishing to put anybody off practicing or trying to improve their golf swing, but you need repetition, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 repetitions with a golf ball in front of you, but deliberately thinking about the positions, not about the result at first. The result will come when the positions on the backswing or whatever it is you're working on starts to happen naturally. Okay, so constructive practice. If you're hitting 30 or 40 balls, as a rough guide, you should probably be there on the range for about an hour and a half to 2 hours, because you're being that deliberate over each golf ball that you hit. Okay, hope that helps. Again, if we can help out in any way, myself or Brad, please give us a call in the shop or email us. Contact details are on the newsletter, and we'll hopefully speak to you soon.